actually mean to, I'm gonna be honest, I don't really mean to watch Oprah, but what happens is that sometimes my TiVo just goes fucking rogue and records whatever it wants. Did your TiVo ever do that, right? Just you programming, telling what you want, and then your TiVo's like, ah, fuck that, I'm gonna record this shit. You'll like it more. It's like a French waiter, they don't give a fuck, they just bring you whatever they think is good. My TiVo started taping all these Oprahs. I'm really learning a lot about myself. But I'm also kind of scared of Oprah now by some of the things that, you know, if you watch Oprah, there's two kinds of Oprah. She's got like a dual persona, Oprah. Okay, there's two kinds of Oprah show. The first Oprah show is a blast. It's like a fun fest. Oprah comes out, the theme music kicks in, Oprah, big Oprah, right? She comes in through the double doors on a skateboard, she ollies off, high fives everybody in the crowd, right? She's all excited, happy. She announces who's on the show, Harrison Ford is here! Then she starts giving away shit to the crowd. You ever see that where she just comes in, she gives everybody cars for absolutely no reason? But it's getting to the point where it's very ostentatious. She's giving away shit that's like way too over the top. She came in the other day, she was like, everybody here gets schools! You get a school, and you get a school! You're all getting schools! And the crowd was like, what the fuck? I don't want a school, Oprah. I don't want... How am I supposed to maintain a faculty and staff? I can't do that. Do I have to pay the mortgage on this fucking school, by the way? Everybody here gets... I can't house a humpback whale. So that's the great, that's the fun Oprah. But then there's another Oprah show that scares the shit out of me. There's a different show. It's a serious, scary Oprah show, right? And you know right away that it's no fucking bullshit because there's not even a theme song when that show starts. You know that episode, right? The show just starts. Oprah doesn't even, she doesn't even make an entrance. She's already standing on stage. Just in the dark, right? She's not even illuminated yet. She's just standing in the darkness. And you know it's no bullshit. You know Oprah's gonna come in with some real hardcore shit because you can even tell in the silhouette that her hair is different. If she has like that poodle crazy hair, that's gonna be a lot of fun, that show. But she's got that, she got that hair pulled back like a lesbian warden. You know what I'm talking about? And you know that show. Oprah's just staring at the camera. Finally that light illuminates. And she's staring right into your soul as you sit watching on your couch, and she talks right to you. She looks right into the camera and she goes, pedophiles. You could be a pedophile. You probably are a pedophile. Right now, you are a pedophile. That was the show the other day. That was the entire show. It was so freaky. It was all about how to protect your family, your kids from rapists and pedophiles. And when she was talking about the show, first thing that she talked about was something that my family used to do growing up. She said you should give your kids like a phrase or a word. Yeah, like a secret word, right? And if a stranger tries to pick you up and tell you that mommy and daddy are in the hospital because their car flipped into a ravine on the way to a party, then you, they don't go with that person unless they know the password or the passphrase. Did you have one? Is that what you had? You're getting so excited. You had that one? Yeah, and here's the thing. It's, we had a passphrase, and I didn't agree with it because our passcode phrase was, hey, kid, do you want some candy? And I didn't agree with this. I felt like that was very similar to what they, like they were setting me up for the diddle, is basically what I felt. So I gotta tell you about this. This was crazy shit. So she keeps talking on the show about a website that you can visit to protect your family. And she's talking about this website. It's called familywatchdog.org, right? She keeps saying, if you go to familywatchdog.org and you type in your address, it'll show you a map and it'll show you all the rapists and pedophiles in your neighborhood. And when she was describing this, I was like, oh, that's cool. Let me fucking see who's in my neighborhood. That's fun shit. I wanna see. So I went to my computer and I typed in my address. And by the way, I do keep my keyboard right on my lips. I know you see this now. I know you're concerned, don't they? It's because for the space bar, I kiss. That's how I do it. That's how I wag it, man. Familywatchdog.org. Guys, don't do this. Do not go to this site. I'm telling you right now. You don't want to know. I went to the site, I typed in my address, and I figured when I hit enter, it would show like my house, and they'd be like, red dots. I hit enter. I live in Rapeville. I live in Rapetopia. There's so many red dots around my little green dot. The red dots were raping my green dot. They were fucking my green dot.